Mahesh, one final question from mine at least. Assuming that the election verdict is what the market would like, what would be your top overweight stance, not just from a next 6 month to 12 month perspective, if you want to give a longer term one than even that?
Yeah, so from a longer term perspective, I continue to believe that the key change in the economic drivers, driving the GDP growth has changed, from the earlier primarily consumption driven factors to now more investment driven factors. And the best way to play that through the stock market would be, overweighting the real estate, sectors and the allied sectors, associated with the housing boom. The second I would still highlight as the power and utilities, because that is still, the sort of place where, there are, there's a considerable, gap in terms of demand supply and likely to stay that way for the next few years to come. So power utilities is the second area. And the third, I would say is the industrial stroke manufacturing. So these three are still the sectors that I would overweight, from the longer term perspective. We still like the state-owned enterprises, the PSU story. We still, like select names, in the PSU banks and some of the oil names and, the mining names, etc. So that is still a story that I would like to own from a longer term perspective as well. Obviously, certain banks, look quite interesting. But I would still definitely make that statement that what has necessarily worked in the last 10 years, we cannot really take it for granted that the same kind of stocks and high quality names and high ROE names will continue to perform in the next 5 to 10 years, because the risk appetite in the economy has gone up, has changed, and the sectors that are benefiting from that are not the ones that benefited in the previous 10 years when there was an element of risk aversion in the economy, not the stock market, the risk aversion in the economy, which was evident in the NPL cycle in the banks, which was evident in the debt to equity levels of the Indian corporates going down. All that is reversing as we speak, and therefore the four sectors that I identified, I think are still the best way to bet from a longer term perspective.
So long term is always exciting, Mahesh, but viewers will not forgive me if I don't ask you, where do you see the Nifty at the end of this calendar year, end of 2024? So many numbers doing the rounds. Once we have elections, etc., out of the way, first budget post the government swearing in, where do you see, what is your internal Nifty number for December 2024, end of December 2024?
Yeah. So end of December 2024, on the Nifty side, or, let's say from the next, 12-month perspective, I would still think that, Nifty, the large cap, index, will give you double digit returns. So I'm still expecting anywhere between 12 to 14% return over the next 12 months, from the large cap Nifty. But obviously for mid caps and small caps, I think, we've seen huge gains already. And the mid cap, small cap returns probably toned down as compared to what we've seen in the last, last 12 months to a much more kind of, moderate, maybe a similar kind of a 10% kind of a number for the mid cap, small caps as well.
Nifty number, where do you think the Nifty will be at the end of the year?
Yeah, I mean, Nifty right now is about 22,700 or so. And as I said, we can do the maths. I'm looking at almost about a 12% kind of a number. So 12 months down the line, so we are talking about in May 2025, will probably be somewhere around 25,000, I would say.
All right. So May 2025, Nifty at 25,000 is a projection by Mahesh Nandurkar, Head of Research and MD at Jefferies India. Fantastic chatting with you, Mahesh. We hope to have the opportunity to speak with you once again soon. So that's a fairly optimistic outlook, I would say, Niraj, all things considered.
Yeah, and identifying themes for us and more. So pretty interesting as to what happens. I think that note on that flows was very, very stable.